Hello and welcome back to the Goodness Margin, the place where we find margin for the good things in life. Many times on social media or on my blog, I am asked a lot of the same questions over and over again. And I have realized that many times these questions can be answered by this book, Michael Hyatt's Free to Focus. I highly recommend that all of you go, you buy this book, you read this book. I usually get most of my books from the library, but as you can see, I've got little tabs in here. I've highlighted this book. This is a book that you want to own because you want to be able to make notes and highlight and all of those things. Today, I want to share with you the top five things that I learned from Michael Hyatt's Free to Focus. So the first thing is Michael asked us to look at our life as we want it to be, sort of an ideal plan. Now, it's not, okay, I want to be vacationing in Aruba all the time. If that is actually your life goal, then you need to make a plan for how that works. The reality is that I feel like I'm living my dream life. I love my life. I love what my husband and I do. I love that we have two kids. I love our home. But there were some things that I wanted to change. And so I began to think about those things. How would I like to feel? I would like for my stress level to be lower. I would like to feel completed with work. These things really made me ask those questions and really take a hard look at what I really wanted my life to be. So that's the first thing that he asked you to do. And I think it's such an important thing to not just go through life blindly, but to really stop and think, what is my purpose with trying to be more productive? What is my purpose with trying to be a minimalist? What do I want to accomplish? The next thing were these two statements. He says that productivity is not about getting more done. It's about getting the important things done. He also talks about achieving more by doing less. This entire concept is so wonderful. You've probably heard me say it before, but I love reading productivity books. I've read a lot of the books about productivity. And so many times it's about just getting more done, just to be more productive, to get more done. And it's just this cycle. However, he talks about the reason we need to be more productive in the right areas is so that we have that freedom. And it really lined up with the things that I had been feeling, that margin for goodness in my life. These concepts are throughout the entire book. How can we be more productive for the right reasons, to get the right things done so that we have freedom, we have margin in our lives. The third thing is eliminate, delegate, automate. He asks you to write an entire list of all of your responsibilities, all of the things that you have to do. I'll be quite honest with you, it was over a year ago that I did this, and it felt kind of overwhelming to really write all of those things down. My husband and I pastor a church. I'm a mom. I want to start a business. I have all of these things. I'm a homeschool mom. Just all of these things that I'm involved in, and writing those lists down, all of those things felt very overwhelming. It's like I almost didn't want to see it all out on paper. But it was such a great activity for me to do that. And actually, when you purchase the book, he has a link where that you can go and download all of these documents to help you do the activities he suggests that you do throughout the book. I highly recommend that you do those. So as you go through that list, you find, what are those things that you can eliminate in your life? What are the things that you're doing that actually don't move you closer to your goal? There are probably things that we're all doing that we need to eliminate in our life. They're not there for a purpose. What are some things that we can delegate? This was really great when I looked at some of the things I did for work and I realized, okay, this is not absolutely necessary. This probably falls under someone else. Or this is something that I could even delegate virtually to something. Another thing is automate. There are a lot of things that we can automate. And he does talk about batch work, which I've actually done an entire blog post and video about batch work that I will link below. But what are the things that we can automate electronically, or it's something that it just becomes an automatic task because we're getting it all done at once. We're using batch work to get those things done. It's all about working smarter. The fourth thing is he talks about quarterly goals. Now, he does do annual goals, but I find that that is just a really big picture to look at. And let's look at 2020. Life has changed drastically throughout this year. So I love the concept of quarterly goals. I also use his planner, the full focus planner, and it is a quarterly planner. I didn't want to bite the bullet. I am very thrifty. My husband had been using this and I was like, no, I feel like it's a little bit expensive. I don't know that I will have another planner. It works just fine. But after reading his book and realizing that the planner lines right up to these concepts, this planner, I think this is my sixth one. I never regret the money that's spent on this because it is so worth it. So as a quarterly planner, it focuses on our quarterly goals. Trying to envision what we're going to do over the next 12 months is overwhelming, but envisioning what we're going to get done over the next 3 months, maybe you do have an annual goal, but let's break it down into bite-sized pieces into the next quarter. This is a really great way to truly accomplish your goals. And number five is my big three task. So he asks you, for each week, to look at what are your big three? What are the three things you're doing this week that are the most important things? And at least one of those needs to be moving you towards one of those goals, not just running through the rat race of life, trying to get the little tasks done, but let's choose the important things that are moving us closer to our goals. And then each day to choose those big three tasks. And then there's a list for the subtask. The thing that this has really helped me with so much is I'm a pretty productive person. I actually enjoy productivity. On a day off, I'm probably going to find a task to do or a project to do because I just enjoy being busy. I don't relax very well. But sometimes that has a negative side to it because I never really felt like I was finished. I always felt like there was more to do. However, whenever I have taken a look at my entire week and I see, okay, what are the three most important things I'm going to do? And I plan out my week, then on Monday, I've checked off those big three. I've checked off my subtask. I truly am done because I know that I have planned correctly and everything's going to be okay. I don't have to keep working until it's time for bed. I can stop and feel finished. That has been a huge transformation for me to find margin in my life, is to feel finished with my tasks. It all comes down to getting the important things done. What are the important things in life that we need to accomplish? And how can we find that freedom? I have taken time off and I do not want my kids to feel like I am just the mom that works all the time. That's all I ever do. Are there days that my daughter is home from preschool and she says, hey, mommy, I want this. And I say, not right now. Let me finish this email. Absolutely. Those are going to happen. But I want my life to have purpose. I want to be productive for the right reasons. And I want to be sure that I am scheduling the really important things, which is the time with my family and the time to accomplish the big life goals that I would like to do. This book has truly made an impact on my life. In fact, I shared it with my boss and we ended up having our entire company read this book because it made such a difference. This is why all of these notes are there, because we had a summer retreat and this was the focus of the entire week. I encourage you to grab this book. I'll have it linked below and you will be able to find margin in your life if you follow the concepts in this book. If you've enjoyed these videos, I would love for you to hit the subscribe button, hit the bell so you'll be notified when the next videos go live. I hope that you're having a great week and that you find margin in your life for the good things.